What's up, ladies and gentlemen? It's Homer Mac, aka KillaDBA, and today I want to talk about my experience at Past Data Community Summit 2022, sponsored by Redgate, hosted by Redgate, sponsored by Microsoft. This is my Uber ticket. I know I just put anything in here. Here's my Delta seating on my Delta flight. You can't take me anywhere, right? I don't get out much. All right, so here I am showing my ticket from Atlanta to Seattle. And this is where they charge for my bag, $30. Okay, whatever. You know what I mean, Delta? It's okay. So this was a great experience, and they called me and asked me if I could write a song for SQL Server 2022, and they put me on the phone with a lot of people who were behind developing SQL Server 2022. That's me in Hartsfield Airport. It was early in the morning. I was sleepy, headed to Seattle to get on the plane, and so there I am, and I wanted to show this. It was interesting. It said no weapons allowed, and here's a little video of it, this little cool contraption spinning around. I just thought that was cool. So I was good sometimes with my mask. Sometimes I had it on, sometimes I didn't. For the most part, I did have it on. This is November 16th at the time, 2022, and here I am on the escalator. And oh, this guy here is my frat brother. He's the first black president of Georgia State. And he's a member of Omega Psi Phi. I've never met him, but his name is Brian Blake, the first black president of Georgia State College. So that's me on the transit trying to get to my gate. A little video, just trying to be good with the mask. Going up an escalator. And so, a little breakfast, you know what I mean, right before the plane. So yeah. So I wrote the song, y'all. It took me, man, maybe a day or two to come up with the concept as far as like the melody. Okay, here's my ticket again. I don't know why I'm showing this. And I think that was the Sheraton information before. So here I am about to board the plane, the Delta flight. Here is the cockpit, but you know, the airplane, front of the airplane where you board. And yeah, I wanted to capture the whole experience, y'all. You know, it's been, I haven't been back to Seattle since 2018. And then I did the virtual in 2020, I think it was, for Summit. I didn't go 2019. So yeah, it's been a while. So I wanted to capture every moment. Here I am on the airplane. And this is where I was actually studying my lyrics for the SQL Server 2022 song. Studied the lyrics on the plane, trying to get it down so that I can know the song. Here I am arriving in Seattle. And so, yeah. That's me, Homer Mac. Headed to the Sheraton Grand in Seattle. That's my little confirmation number. And it was a quick trip, as you can see. Check in was November 16th, check out November 18th. And then I got there like around, you know, 12:30 in the afternoon, and I leave 3 o'clock on Friday. So it was a quick trip. Here's the key to my room. I thought that was cool. Welcome to the summit. Hello again. That was good marketing. Our keys was, had that info on it to the room. There I am at my room. Man, I took a lot of pictures and giving it to y'all, I guess. I don't know. So, okay, room 622. That's where I was in the Sheraton, just hanging out. Okay, there I am getting ready to go and check out the exhibit hall where all the vendors are set up. Got my Atlanta Hawks hat on, trying to represent. They had a game that night against Boston. Not sure who won. So here I am in Seattle. So this is now the Seattle Convention Center. It used to be the Washington Convention Center, but now it is the Seattle Convention Center in 705 Pike. A lot of changes in Seattle, and a lot of people were talking about that. So here are the room locations and the things, you know, nice display, marketing display that Redgate or whoever who was over this did a great job. I thought it was cool. Welcome home. It's been long. It's been too long. I was trying to read that banner. There I am again. Got my Hawks hat on, and I'm headed to the exhibit hall where I will see all the different vendors and whatnot. So I saw this right here, this Redgate Together Again 2022 had the Seattle needle right there. That was kind of cool. And so this guy that worked there was like, hey man, I'll get a picture of you. And I gave him my phone and he took a picture of me right here. Selfie time. So that was cool. Then I took a picture of this Microsoft keynote room 4A because I knew that on Friday, this is Wednesday, right? On Friday, I knew Friday morning, this is where I would be performing my SQL Server 2022 song and HuggaDBA song. I performed HuggaDBA as well. So I just wanted to get a picture of that because I couldn't believe I was going to actually perform there. Bag pickup. So yeah, I actually did get a bag. And that's where you register. I registered. That's my badge. Once I registered, I got my badge. And then let's flip that around so we can see it. Here we go. There we go. McEwen Media LLC. I actually went as myself this time representing my company, McEwen Media LLC. You can go to McEwenMedia.com and check me out. So there is the DataVail booth. What's up? Shout out to DataVail. Redgate. They had a nice booth as well, right there front and center. You already see it. You know what? Gonna do some me and DataVail. We talking. Those are my buddies there. I'm looking forward to talking to them a little bit more. That is the Microsoft booth intel. There you go. That is Miss Olivia. Olivia, she's a Microsoft senior event manager. She works with dynamic events. Had a little food there. I was eating a little food because I was hungry. That is Miss Ree, y'all. She's a senior program manager, data engineering, MVP lead, director of data community at Microsoft. What's up, Ree? I got to get you another one of those t-shirts. You said you didn't have it. That's an inside joke. She's so fun to talk about and tease about that. So there I am. Headed out. Where am I going now? Oh, I'm going to perform that evening at the exhibit hall. I actually performed a couple of songs in between presentations at the Microsoft booth. So yeah, I performed Microsoft SQL Server 2019. That's the first time I ever performed that song. That was fun. I'm in love with an IT girl. HuggaDBA. So those were the three songs I performed, and I had a lot of fun doing that, y'all. That was so cool. So here's more food, and here are, they were really nice, so I took a picture of them. They were serving the food and whatnot. Hey, so this is Nikki and Rachel. They're with Dynamic Events as well, and that's Miss Olivia. Olivia, Nikki, and Rachel, and they were really nice and showing me where to go and how to do things and giving me t-shirts and stuff. And you can see AWS was in the house, Redgate. What's up, Ryan? That's Mr. Ryan Booze. I think I pronounced your name right. He was with, he's an advocate, a PostgreSQL advocate. That's Patrick LeBlanc. What's up, man? That's Guy in the Cube. Everybody knows Patrick. What's up, Eric? Eric is my buddy. We work together at BCD Travel. We both don't work there anymore, but he is my liaison. He introduced me to everybody at PAS. He's so popular. That is Miss Alicia Moniz. I hope I pronounced it right. She's a data and AI specialist at Microsoft. And here are two young ladies. They were so nice. They were over the Microsoft Learning, and they were telling me, you know, how to, you know, which way to go if I wanted to get certified and where, what website to go to with Microsoft if I was interested in training and learning. And they were really nice. What's up, David? That's David Pless, principal program manager at Microsoft. What's funny is he and I both worked at BCD Travel at different times, though. And he's a really cool guy. He helped me put in words that I was going to actually include in the 2022 song. That is Miss Odette. I met her and she was so sweet. She said, I love your songs. I always send your songs and share them with people on my team. And I thought that was so cool. Okay, Carlos, I need to get in touch with him because he has a podcast and he said we need to talk. So these are my sake shots at a sushi restaurant that I went to with Eric Peterson and a few other people. And that's Miss Christy, he introduced me to. She is a data enthusiast as well. It was so nice meeting her. And this guy is really cool. He's from Australia. His name starts with B. My apologies. He was so nice and really cool. And really enjoyed talking with him as well. And this is the sushi. I wish I knew the name of this place. It was so good. And if I go back, when I go back to Seattle, I'm definitely going to go back to this place. And this was explaining these are the sake shots that I had. Wanted to show the cool ambiance of this place and just show what it was like. And this guy, this is Bernard. He and I, Went to the same high school, have not seen this guy since 1985, and he's a DBA. That's so crazy. That's Adam with Guy in the Cube, Eric Peterson, and we were at the Sheraton just hanging out. And hey, Miss Catherine, hadn't seen her in a while, next to Patrick there on the right, and we're all just hanging out. So this is the next day. This is Thursday. Got my Georgia Tech sweatshirt on. I'm just trying to, even though I'm a UGA Bulldog, got my master's from Georgia Tech, so I was, sporting the Georgia Tech that day. Anyway, so just showing a few more pictures. I signed up for this table tennis tournament that Dale was sponsoring, and I was like, I can play table tennis. I know how to play ping pong. Building a culture that embraces diversity, equity, and inclusion. It was so awesome. Andrea Kay did that. It was so cool. So here's where I registered for the table tennis thing. DB Visit. Hello, Miss Kelly. Kelly Burns with DB Visit Software. She was so sweet. She gave me a t-shirt. That is Matt. He was like the stage manager and directing us when we were at rehearsal. That's Steve Jones. Y'all know Steve. Redgate, Sequel Central, Sequel Saturdays. He's so cool. Kimberly Tripp, y'all. That's Kimberly and Paul Randall and Sequel Skills. And look, there's my sticker. I think she put my sticker on her surface, which was so cool. Or was that Olivia's? I can't remember. That's Bob Ward, ladies and gentlemen. This is Mr. Bob Ward, Principal Architect at Microsoft. He wrote the SQL Server 2022 reveal book. Go get it. It is awesome. I'm reading it right now. And I took a picture with Bob. And Bob also was instrumental in helping me with the lyrics of the 2022 song, along with this guy right here, Mr. Ajay, Product Management Leader for SQL Server and Azure Arc Data Services at Microsoft. Ajay was like, yeah, you need to put these lyrics in and make sure you say this and that. And that really helped me. Shout out to my frat brothers, Omega Psi Phi. That day was November 17th, so I had to represent in Seattle for Omega Psi Phi. This is Bob Ward doing his presentation and talking about SQL Server and how it connects to Azure interchangeably. And it was a really cool presentation. I'm hoping that it's up on the PaaS Summit site. I want to check it out again because it was an awesome presentation. So that was Bob Ward giving his presentation at the Microsoft booth at the exhibit hall in the Seattle Convention Center. And that is Miss Ginger, y'all. This is, she is so sweet, Miss Ginger Desert Isle. She was one of the first people I ever met when I went to SQL Server. And that's me. That's when I went to PaaS back in 2017. This guy right here is a magician, Danny Orleans. He's corporate magic guy, and he's so cool. Y'all just don't understand. All right, so this was a description of Kimberly Tripp's keynote presentation, which was really good. I suggest you guys go check it out. But yeah, back to Ginger. She was so sweet. It was so good to see her. Desert Isle SQL. Go check her out. So this is Kendall Van Dyke, Senior Program Manager at Microsoft. And he also helped me out with the lyrics. And this is a shot of me in Seattle that evening. Headed to Seattle Spin, which is a nice restaurant atmosphere that specializes in table tennis, ping pong. And you know, guys, I brag a lot about being a great ping pong player. But I got spanked that night in the tournament by a guy named Duck. Guys, if you see Duck, tell him I want a rematch. Because let me tell you, I was so sleepy, y'all. I was sleepwalking. I was so sleepy. And so I know that's not an excuse, but Duck, he really laid it on me. But I can really give him a run for his money if I were myself. So, hey, Duck, if you're listening, hey, I want a rematch. So this is the place. It's so nice. It's my second time being. I actually performed in here last time I was here, 2018. And it was so awesome. They were bringing us food. There were, it was drinks flowing. It was just in here. You could see the tournament, the different branches and moving up. I won by default because the first guy never showed up. So I did win one of my games. I don't know why I have this AMD picture. It looked cool on the screen, so I took it. Shout out to AMD. Dell was sponsoring this through PaaS, which was really cool. And so it was a fun time. And I took my sweatshirt off, so I was getting serious on them. I was gonna show them. But I lost, and I was like, good, because I can go home. What's up, Craig? That is Craig Ellis with Redgate. He helped me with all my, with going to rehearsal and the videos I needed to take care of to get it to him so I can perform. This was a guy, I don't know him, but he was just hanging out in the ping pong balls, laying down in it. I was like, man, that's making me even more sleepy. I need to go home and get some rest. I remember thinking that as I took that picture. So this is the next day. This is like 6 in the morning, 6:30 when I got dressed and ready for the keynote presentation before Kimberly Tripp's keynote. It was such an honor to open up for her. Check out those shoes, though, those Jordans. Who does this guy think he is? Ooh, I ain't gonna lie, those Jordans kind of fresh. It's a long story on why I wear that hat, y'all. And yeah, I just kind of, that's my little branding, KillaDBA, I wear the hat. And I've been asked by Microsoft, hey, can you wear the hat? I'm like, oh, okay, they like the hat, so I wear the hat, and it's cool, you know, I like it. It's cool. Okay, so here is before everybody, it's the room before everybody came. And to be honest, the room, it's not as packed as it has been in previous past events. And that's because they're rebuilding after the pandemic. And that's okay. It's still the room that I wanted to perform in. I saw a tweet that I tweeted in 2018 where I said, hey, one day my dream is to perform on that stage. Dreams come true. I performed on the stage. Those were cool, nostalgic SQL Server boxes of material that Kimberly Tripp had. These are the confident monitors that I used to as my SQL Server 2022 song was playing, because that really helped and took a lot of stress out, because that was a lot of words I had to learn and creating that song in a short period of time. This is like backstage, you know, scenes before the people came early that morning. And mind you guys, like I said, the show started at 8 in the morning. We had to be there for makeup at 7. Isn't that funny? Makeup. But yeah, they needed to knock the shine off my head. Look at those Jordans though. Shout out to my brother-in-law Bo and my sister for buying me those shoes for my birthday. This was a monitor in the back, in the green room, if you will. And this is me chilling back there, just kind of relaxing before I go on, checking out the snacks, trying to decide, do I want any? Probably not. A little nervous. Let me just chill out and just wait for it to happen. People started coming in and whatnot, and so I was just waiting in the back and going over the words of my songs, Hugga DBA. Oh, I ain't gonna lie, y'all, check out those Jordans right there. They kind of fresh retros. I don't know, I like them though. And so, you know, I had to take a picture of them. They gave me confidence. I ain't gonna lie, I'm not a sneakerhead or anything, but all right, so this is the makeup lady's makeup. And I just wanted to get a shot of the whole experience. And there she is. I can't remember her name, but she was so sweet. She put makeup on your boy. So that's me and Miss Kimberly Tripp. And it's so fun and cool to meet her after all these years of, you know, going to her website and using her scripts to help me out in my profession as a DBA. Ooh, your boy got the makeup on. I don't know, I kind of look better without the makeup, I think. But you said it's all good, your boy got makeup on. So that's me with the makeup on. Shoes again as I'm getting ready to perform. So it was my turn. Hey, that was a shot of Miss Ginger in the promo video before things got kicked off. I thought that was cool. Are you sitting comfortably? So, you know, I could see everything that was going on in the back with that monitor. I had a couple of monitors, actually. I really must like these shoes because I'm showing. Oh, there he is. So this is a little snippet. If you want to see this, go to the Past TV YouTube channel and you can see the whole video under Kimberly Tripp's keynote. Oh, look, Kimberly hugged me when I was doing Hugga DBA. That was pretty cool. And so this is the Do More For Less SQL Server song. Let me give y'all a little taste of it real quick of what I had to do. Let me see if I can remember. Well, I can see the words right here, so that helps me out. Here we go. Check it out. Cloud connected database through Management Studio, most consistent data platform you will ever know. Intel Quick Assist backup compression, extending TCQL with JSON, always encrypted enhancement, buffer pool parallel scanning, digital trust is established, automatic digest storage, you can back it up and restore it to Azure now. I gotta say one more thing about Codename Dallas, aka 16. I'll be happy with hands-free TempDB. Actually, Bob Ward, can I get a copy? Possibly for free? Man, give me a key. Anyway, that was fun, y'all. These are pictures that people sent me afterwards, or I saw on Twitter that I snagged, and I thought it was so cool. So I was like, yeah, let me get these pictures. The cowboy hat. So I put the cowboy hat in between songs, Hugga DBA and SQL Server 2022, because that's the code name for 2022 Dallas, because Bob Ward is from Dallas, and he named it. So That's why I have the cowboy hat on. And that was after my performance. Kimberly thanked me and said it was nice and stuff, and that was really cool. And there she is giving her presentation about 30 years of innovation with SQL Server. It was really cool. My first experience with SQL Server was in 2000 with version 6.5. She actually goes before that in like early 90s to talk about earlier versions of SQL Server, which were very interesting to me. So you guys go check that video out as well. These guys were in the back. I don't even know what that picture was about. That was me in the back watching her presentation. I was able to watch it from the back. And again, like I said, she and Paul did an awesome job. Check them out at SQLskills.com. They are superstar consultants, and they know all the ins and outs about SQL Server. And so here they are again, doing their thing in the back. It's me watching them on the monitor. And it was just really good to go back in time. You know what I'm saying? Query Analyzer. Who remembers Query Analyzer? SQL Server 2000. This was afterwards, y'all. Hey, that's the back of Steve Jones. Check this out. That reminded me of the Lego Steve that was everywhere. Redgate Pro, this Lego Steve. And there he is, y'all. Look, with the cowboy hat and the Hawaiian shirt on. That's so cool. And this was afterwards when everybody was clearing out. I kind of peeked my head out and saw how fast the room cleared out that morning, and talked to a few people, and it was really cool, and it was nice, and people were real receptive about it. Okay, SQL Server, look at the Microsoft SQL Server materials from back in the day. I wanted to take a picture of that. SQL Server 2000 Enterprise Edition. These were Kim's, these are her things, her materials. Look at that, she still has this stuff, which is really cool. What's up, Ajay? Again, guys, this is Ajay. He's with Microsoft, and he helped me to guide me on what words to say. What's up? This is a picture we took with Kimberly, Tripp, and Paul, and some other people. That's Miss Amy from Salt Lake, Utah. She was so cool. She was always saying, yup. I thought that was so funny. She was so cool. So I went back for a last little visit to the exhibit hall and wanted to, you know, talk to a few more people before I left. Network a little bit, you know what I mean? So this was the last hurrah because my plane was leaving at 3 o'clock. So let's see. SQL Server runs best in the cloud. Visit us at booth 401, such as AWS. So that is Mr. Brent Ozar, everybody. BrentOzar.com. He's a SQL Server consultant, and he makes SQL go fast. Everybody knows Brent. And this is DataVale. This is Amanda and Donna, and they were so cool with DataVale. This is Ann Hoffman with Data Expose. It was so good finally meeting her. I love her videos. And this is my buddy John with Procure SQL and his wife, their principal consultants, and she's a Delta. She's in sorority Delta Sigma Theta, and she recognized my Omega Psi Phi bag and told me happy anniversary. And this is, these are Fortified, and that is Andrea Kay, and I think her name is Barb, and they were so cool, and I enjoyed her presentation. And what's up, Tony from the Netherlands, I believe. You said you're going to make me a beat, man. You said you're going to turn some of my stuff with, put house music behind it. And that's really it, ladies and gentlemen. This is the end of everything. I'm about to leave, and I was just taking every little picture. It's like, I can't believe I performed in that keynote room. That was a dream that I had been saying that I wanted to do ever since I started going to PASS in 2017. That was my first PASS event. I knew about PASS, but could never get to PASS. Okay, look, guys, this is where they clean the room out. I left my cowboy hat in the back in the green room, so I had to run and get it. When I went back, boom, they had already cleared this place out. All the chairs were gone. It looked like a totally different place with the lights on, right? They were cleaning house. So I don't know, put my ticket in there again. This is just stuff from my photos, right? And this is my Uber from the Sheraton to the Seattle airport. And leaving Seattle, leaving the Sheraton, got my bag and I'm ready, got my Hawks hat again. It was fun. It was a quick hit, y'all. If I can go back, I would have probably made a trip out of it and extended my stay a little bit. This is me getting on the plane. This is just me taking pictures of the plane. And let me tell y'all, when I got home, I was sick. It's like my body said, we're going to wait until you get home. And then boom, we went to the mountains of Georgia, North Georgia mountains, and I was sick the whole trip we were there. Welcome to Atlanta. Welcome to the A. So I'm back in Atlanta. This is Hartsfield Airport, little scene people may recognize, headed back. So yeah, this was a great experience, y'all. This is like my fourth time being in Seattle performing, and Past summit did not let down. It was a great experience. I met a lot of people. I learned a lot. It really boosted my passion for the profession that I'm in and learning more about data. And now that the cloud is integrated with SQL Server, oh, there I am sick, y'all. I was sick. Your boy had the flu. I had a temperature and everything. I did not have COVID. I took two tests. Hey, SQL Server 2022 out on all digital platforms. You can hear it on Spotify. You can hear it on iTunes. And that is a wrap, ladies and gentlemen. I really enjoyed
KillaDBA's
hanging out in Seattle for PaaS Data Community Summit. All right, until next time. Peace.